For continue our subject of this morning, until symbolic codes, page 10, I believe that's where we left off. This is the 20th day of March, isn't it? The first day of spring. Pardon? Well, 2021 is the first day of spring. Put it that way. Yes. All right. Well, spring is here. We all. So it's the last paragraph. So just as there were three sections or divisions of the church, and what were the divisions of the church called? Some of the three divisions we learned this morning under what symbol? What was the third? Well, it is symbolized by the Trinity. But what section? Under what represents the church? E was the first section, wasn't it? And what was the second section, Sarah? Hagar, the second. And the third was Sarah. Now then, it says just as there were three sections or divisions of the church, so also there are three sections of the true priesthood. And so we have what? Three sections of the priesthood. What's number one? Melchizedek. What's number two? Aaronic priesthood. And number three priesthood is what? Right. After the order of Melchizedek, three divisions. Now, this chart here on the board, found in 1 Second Rob 224, shows that there are two divisions of this Melchizedek priesthood, right? When you compare that chart there with the chart in 12 symbolic codes, you see that this chart here on the board in 1 Second Rob is showing two divisions of that priesthood, right? The first, under Adam and Eve in their purity. And second, under the figure of Melchizedek, King of Salem. That's two divisions. And how long did that priesthood last? Now, one priesthood merges into another. That should give you a clue. Yes. That Melchizedek priesthood lasted until Moses came on the scene. And how long did Moses' priesthood last? The Aaronic priesthood. Until Jesus came on the scene, right? Well, we have the same thing in the time. When Jesus came on the scene, the priesthood was changed. When Moses came on the scene, the priesthood was changed, wasn't it? So we have three changes in the priesthood, don't we? Now, as I said, coming back to the time of Jesus, when he came and became a priest, the priesthood was changed. And as we said this morning, in the antichrist, you must have a change in the priesthood, right? If the type and the antitype are alike. So that necessitates now a change of the priesthood from the order of Melchizedek back to the priesthood of Melchizedek. Which in its purest form was under Adam and Eve. Right? Two intercessors, in other words. Now Romans tells us that the Holy Spirit and Jesus are the two intercessors, right? That's been made plain to us, hasn't it? All right. We have a change of the priesthood in the antitype, I say. And we're coming back to the original. where you have a man and a woman representing the church and the priesthood in one family. That's what it is. That's the truest form of the priesthood, the church and her priesthood. Now, you must admit that Adam and his family represented the first church on earth. Can't you? Can't you see that? How many see that? Do you see that, Sydney? That Adam and Eve and their family represented the first church on earth in the beginning. And in it, you had the representation of the fathers, the mothers, and the children. In other words, you had a true representation of the Trinity, right? Now, the revelation shows, according to the creation, that in the beginning, God is one. He was one. Why do I say that? Because of the way Adam was created. At first, it was just Adam, wasn't it? And he represented Eve and the children in one person, right? And then they had Eve separated from Adam, showing the mother, the female figure in the Trinity. And after that, they had the children separated from the mother. You see a division of the one God, don't you? It's one God in three divisions. Could you say that, Sydney? Why couldn't you say that?
Because God is always three persons. In the very creation, you cannot see when God began. I understand God to be three persons, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, from all eternity. I'm not conceiving them as having been separated in the sense that you are saying, in the sense that Adam was put to sleep and the blood was taken out and then Eve was created. I don't see God being separated that
way. Well, you have to have the Spirit to see that. You have to have spiritual eyesight to see that. That's what it says. Because God reproduced himself on earth in the way that it was in heaven. And he started first with one man. That's why the Jews said there's just one God. That's all it was revealed to them. They didn't accept the second person of Godhead because they didn't believe he was God. That's the furious problem today, Sydney. They never saw a separation. But the problem with some is that they've seen the separation all the way along and they didn't know what time it took place.
I don't see separation.
You don't see a separation into three persons?
Not in the way that you're saying it, no.
Well, how would you know you weren't there?
You
weren't there. Well, I'm there through the eye of faith.
Well,
that's the way I know it. Because 134 of the book Education says that invisible things, even the divinity of God, is revealed by creation, the things he made. God has to be understood before we can be like him.
There's nothing made to show what God is like without having to make any kind of application. You cannot understand God's character perfectly if you make it.
Some can. But the Bible says, Ephesians says, the invisible things are caught by the visible. Now tell me if God is visible. Look it up, Sister John, somebody. Since the visible things teach us about the invisible things. That's in Ephesians. Now, can you take the word of God, Sydney?
Okay.
All right, then you have to believe that the invisible things up there in heaven, which include the Trinity, and which include the angels, are revealed through the visible things.
That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
It just is lessened, though. It's because man has lost the knowledge of nature. Such as I say, it's only through divine inspiration that nature can be understood. So it takes a revelation by the Spirit for you to understand it.
Yeah.
And if you don't understand it, it's because you haven't had a revelation of the Spirit.
God is always
in
people's souls.
Adam wasn't always three persons. And he was made in the very image of God. So explain that. No, you can't if you don't have the understanding. I am showing you that God uses nature to tell you about himself. That's what the prophet
says.
In perfect nature, I'm saying the nature now, no. No. In the beginning, God created every living thing by a divine blueprint, Brother Hottam says. Can you accept that? I said a divine blueprint, excuse me. I said a divine blueprint. But you're not answering me. God made everything on earth, Brother Hottam says, from a divine blueprint in heaven. Brother Bell? Yes. Right. He said, I am the express image of my Father. That's what Sister Wyman is telling us. Even the divinity of God is revealed by the visible creation. And Jesus was a creation in the flesh by the Holy Spirit. That was a creation of Jesus in the flesh. It was an act of creation to bring forth a child from a fleshly mother from God. That was a miracle. And if you don't believe in miracles, you can't see God. Because he is demonstrated in the visible creation. And all creation, it wasn't until Adam named the animals that he saw that he did not have a mate, a companion. It was through the naming of the animal kingdom that Adam realized that he did not have a mate. And God saw fit to give him one. What lesson do you think that was demonstrating? Now we know that Jesus was separated, don't we? From the Trinity, didn't he?
I don't understand.
I said, I'm talking about literal facts. I said, you know that, don't you? I don't ask you if you understand it the way I do. I said you know that Jesus was separated at an appointed time from the Trinity, don't you? You're just shadowboxing. Well, you're not trying, Sidney. You're not trying to understand what I mean. Separated. He'll never be joined back to the Trinity as he was. He identified himself with us, then the flesh. Therefore, he is eternally separated through the flesh from the Trinity. No, I'm sorry. Does anyone else know what I mean in here? Is it too difficult for you to understand that? Show me your hand if you cannot understand it. Well, I said since you can't understand it.
Well, Jesus left heaven and left, he separated himself when he came down.
Yes. That's a matter of record. It's a matter of record, of history. No one can controvert that. No one can.
you have to find something that makes you explain it, because we're out there going to agree and explain it and understand it.
Darkness.
So we have to find something that makes you explain it.
Now explain it, Brother Roden.
So if you have the faith of a grain of mustard seed.
It just takes a very little common faith to see it.
You know what happens to a mustard seed? When it sprouts, there's two hairs that divide, and the little seed comes up the same.
That's a trinity, isn't it? Now that's all it takes. Nature.
It was just one of the
first. Yeah. And it's taught over and over again in every aspect of nature.
All you have to have is the faith of the grain of mustard seed. You take this mountain, you can hear over there.
Praise the Lord. One little thing tells you the story.
I don't see that half the person or half the city understand the Trinity in order to get hungry.
Amen.
A person will have to understand the Trinity in the light of mustard seed is to move the mountain.
But I'll tell you, Claire, I just want to tell you, Nurses, one thing. Your work will be fruitless unless you teach the Trinity. Unless your ministry concentrates on the Trinity, you cannot work with God in repopulating the earth and heaven. You will not get a harvest. Pardon,
you won't get people moving. You won't have the energy to get them moving to God.
Never in this world. That's right. Brother James?
You still have the spiritual being, doesn't
he? He was a glorified body, but he was fleshly. He said that to Thomas, didn't he? And he didn't change, did he? And he's still right up there in the sanctuary right at this hour, offering his blood from his nail-print hand. In the spirit, though he's flesh. He is resurrected a glorified body, but he is still flesh and blood. Otherwise, he would have nothing to offer. Yes. Between them both. Right, we can't reach the Father, Clark, without two intercessors. And if you're looking for the branch key, you're looking to the branch key only, and you want to bypass the branch key as represented by the Holy Spirit, you're not going to have the connection. You're not going to get the right connection. But it's just like Brother Roden said, it's simple. You just take one little mustard seed. It's one, isn't it? But when life begins to come into it, when it begins to sprout, you see two halves separated, don't you? Two halves separated, and a little sprout coming up between. And that is three, isn't it? Three parts of the seed. Well, there are three parts of the human family. There are three parts of the spiritual family. Three persons of the Godhead. And they are revealed at different times. Just like Adam was revealed first, Eve was revealed second, and Christ was revealed a third in the family picture. Now, how could you get closer to God than that? In the order of revelation, in the family tree, it's God, the Holy Spirit, and Jesus, isn't it? The mother, the father, and the child in the family picture. How else could it be? And we read this morning that only God can reveal that in from the beginning. And I want to know what you think about this. Verse 4 of Isaiah 41.
It says, who hath loved and done it, calling the generations from the beginning, I the Lord, the first and with the last. God was the first to be revealed, God the Father. And naturally, he would be with the last one that is revealed. There would be two revelations, wouldn't it? First the Father, the Mother, and then the Son. It's the Holy Spirit that reveals the Father, and it is the Holy Spirit that reveals the Son. The Holy Spirit is the mouthpiece of the Father and the Son. Isn't that right, Reuben?
Well,
it says that. All right, read it for us, Brother Roden.
I couldn't hear anybody on the tape to see it when they come up there to talk.
When you're talking in class, be sure you speak up.
Thinking of the Abraham says, the Father says, now consider how great this man was, unto whom even the patriarch Abraham gave the tenth of the spirit. And there they that are of the sons of Levi, who received the office of the priesthood, and the commandment to take tithes of the people according to the law, that is, of their brethren. So they come out of the loins of Abraham. But he whose descent is not counted from them, receives tithes of Abraham, and blessed him that he that had the promise. And without all contradiction, the less is blessed of the better. And here men that die receive tithes, but where he receiveth them, of whom it is witness that he liveth. And as I may say so, Levi, who receiveth tithes, paid tithes to Abraham, for he was yet in the loins of his father in Melchizedek method.
Well, what does that mean?
It's made the first change to Christian from Levi to Melchizedek. That's the male sacrifice. Why, then you have the things of law. The best way of things of law, huh? The best things of law, and the sacrifice of the animal, the sacrifice of the people for mediating, that is, the sacrifice of people, the Son of God.
But it has to be changed as Jesus the best, because he had yet to die. But after he died, he made a sacrifice, and they couldn't came back again, because he died that we might live and not die. He said, have to go back in and back again.
So you mean, you could say that Jesus is dead and the ones who are not
dead? But then it's going to be like and so that's his
soul. Well, he is. He is. Matter of fact,
from the transcendent, wasn't he?
Okay.
Right. That's right.
They were having a
Father, and Brother Hannah says that Abraham was the spiritual father on earth, and that Sarah was the spiritual mother on earth, representing a spiritual father in heaven and a spiritual mother in heaven. That's what she had. And Isaac was the child that represented Christ. These things are spiritually discerned. Ever since Adam and Eve, every mother that was called thought she was going to be the mother of the Messiah, right? But Jewish women still do. That's right. There is a group of religious Arabs that wear a blousy handloom for the express purpose of carrying the Messiah. They think the man is going to give birth to the Messiah. Mm-hmm. Look how false that is. That's not according to nature, is it? Well, you're saying the same thing if you say three persons, the Godhead or male. That's just the corruption of that. It has many different faces, but the people in the world that don't know God, who have not been in contact with Christianity, know there's something there, but they can't explain it. It's just through the Trinity that it can be explained. And it's so simple, but it's difficult for the learning. He says, then the three sections of the priesthood lines up thus. In the period from Adam and Eve to the time of Israel, the Melchizedek priesthood lasted until this time, when the 12 tribes of Israel went out and came to Mount Sinai and received the law of the Levitical priesthood. Number two, the Christian era, we have the Levitical priesthood. Now, when Jesus came on the scene right here, he lived under the Levitical priesthood, didn't he? And he observed all the rites of the Levitical priesthood. Number three, in the Christian period, we have the priesthood of Christ himself. So much for the priesthood. Now, I'll tell you, in the purest sense, Christ did not represent Melchizedek, did he? Why did I say that? He never died for the main part, did he? Melchizedek, if you read about him.
Yes. He had no father and he had no mother. And he has no
name. Now that can't be said of Jesus, can it? Can it? Can't be said that he didn't have a mother, can it? And can't say that he didn't have a father. No earthly parentage, because Jesus did have earthly parentage. Otherwise, we would never have known him, would we? And it was his choice that it was that way. And who are we to say anything about it? He gave us a demonstration, didn't he? Didn't Jesus give us a demonstration of heaven?
Yeah, he said, what is the cross? He said, such as his mother, and then he said, well, he is my mother.
Right. Jesus had two mothers. He had a spiritual mother and he had a fleshly mother.
So today we have a fleshly mother and we have a spiritual mother. Each and every one of us do. If we're like Christ.
You haven't had a sacrifice really. Why? You could have been a sacrifice for us.
If you get the point that I'm talking about.
If he hadn't have taken the flesh like we are.
He couldn't have had a chance.
Right, because if he had come as God, it wouldn't be a fair representation, would it?
No.
Because we don't have that power. We don't have any more power than Jesus had in the flesh.
That's right.
But that's sufficient, isn't it? Because that's the power of the Spirit.
Yeah.
The third member of the Godhead.
No, he
doesn't
have any more power than we have.
Right, that's why it says. And we certainly don't have any more power than he has. But he doesn't have any more than we have access to, that's why it says. And that should be a great encouragement to us. Now, if we have not been satisfied with our ministry in the branch, if we have not been bringing enough people into the branch, it's because we have not known about the Trinity and what it means to the branch family. But now since we know about the family Trinity on earth to represent the family Trinity in heaven, now you're going to reproduce.
Yes.
The church is going to reproduce and have many, many children.
144,000.
Absolutely.
Yeah. A great number,
Terry.
That
no man can number.
Right. The
first
we're going to have the
way sheep. Right.
Doesn't say how many
way sheep. The way sheep represents a multitude. Right? Unnumbered multitudes. So look what's the head of us, class. That's right. They were a mixture. From the beginning with Abel, down to the end, our time. Now, why does this show up here, class? We have a harvested 1 year round of harvest, as depicted by the life of Jesus beginning with his ministry at the Feast of Tabernacles. And we have a demonstration of the Holy Spirit in 7 years ministry. 7 years. But this is a representation of a harvest in 1 year. Now every year we have a harvest, don't we, class? We have a wave sheep of Passover. We have wave loaves of Pentecost. We have a multitude at the Feast of Tabernacles. That's the promise, at least. And if you observe the year harvest every year, you're going to see a great increase in numbers now because we have the third person of the Godhead represented in the message. Now that's what you have been lacking so far. We've had the knowledge of the Father. We've had the knowledge of the Son. Now we're going to get the knowledge of the Holy Spirit, the third person of the Godhead, to bring in a great multitude. I say, praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Now it takes the faith of a grain of mustard seed to believe that. This mountain of Mount Carmel has to be moved just the same as the one at Washington, D.C. Do you believe that? Do you, Danny?
Yeah.
Do you believe that we're going to have to move to Jerusalem?
Yes.
Yeah. So why are we talking about Seventh-day Adventists moving if we're not ready to move? That would be a disgrace, wouldn't it?
You mean we're going to have to get a next church house move?
Looks like it. Now there has been. We haven't had our ear to the ground, have we?
You
don't understand, Dr. Dowd. Why did we go down? The old famous expression Brother Roden uses, you can't give something you don't have. So you can't give anyone the knowledge of the Holy Spirit if you don't have it. And it is a divine revelation. It has to be revealed to you by the Spirit. That's how you'll know. The Holy Spirit witnesses with your spirit. The spirit that's in the man witnesses with the Holy Spirit. And it has to be open and waiting and ready to receive. That's the only way we can have it. Now, do you think this afternoon that we can go ahead and finish the work at the rate we've been doing it, Sydney? You think we can? No. I think it's utterly impossible. So I beseech the Lord to give His Spirit to the Branch family that the work may be finished. That we're going to Haggai and Zechariah with the Spirit's power that the temple was built in the time. Two people helped build the temple in the time. Terry?
How can we say that the branch of the church of all churches and it's still going on? So I think I can see now how that applies. That's the branch of the church in that 7 year period. That will be the church of all churches.
That 7 years will fly by before you can turn around. But we don't have that 7 years ourselves right here. That's right. Yes, the fulfilled brain.
But I can really apply to that 7 years.
The branch will be 30 years old in 7 years. Want it to me? Man will be 30 years old in 7 years. Honey? That's right.
Yes.
Well, I have a little reading here that was handed to me. It's in volume 8, page 194. It says, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit are seeking and longing for channels through which to communicate to the world the divine principles of truth. In other words, the Trinity is seeking to communicate the truth about themselves in this earth. That's what it is. That's all the Bible's about. You said so this morning, you can see that. Volume 8, paragraph 1, page 168. What is needed now is the free working of the Holy Spirit on our minds and hearts. Without this, our efforts are fruitless. Unless the Spirit molds and fashions us, our words and acts will reveal heartfelt... I don't understand. Let me repeat. The Holy Spirit is seeking to work our mind and our heart. Without this, if it doesn't work our mind and our heart, our efforts are fruitless. When the Spirit molds and fashions us, our words and acts will reveal heartfelt thanksgiving. So how many here want to thank the Lord for what He's done for us? I do. I want to thank the Lord for a resurrection from death unto life. Of those of us who are dead in trespasses and sin, to a new life. It's possible when we learn how to appropriate the gift. I haven't learned how yet, but I'm going to with the help of God. How about you? Aren't we, Sydney? Yes, it's through the enlightenment of the Spirit that can be done. We have someone that has a song.
Yes.
Yes.
Got the money for that. The money is taken from the white.